All right, so I'm sitting here with another local at the Peacock. Is that what it's called? And you still have your mask on. Would you like to remove your mask or can you keep it on?
I can keep it on if we need to. Take it off? Okay.
There you go. You're the first person I've talked to in Corvallis who actually took off their mask.
Okay.
Yeah.
I'm vaccinated, so I feel a lot more safe taking it off because I am vaccinated.
I feel the same way. I had it, and I got vaccinated,
okay.
And they still want to see my card, so it's a little weird.
Okay.
Strange.
Okay.
You know what I mean? So what do you do?
I work at a pizza place. I work at, it's in Albany, but I work at a pizza place. It's called Pizza Amore.
So Albany, New York, or?
Albany, Oregon.
Oh, okay. There's an Albany, Oregon.
It's pretty close.
What I found is that Oregon steals a lot of names of other cities.
Okay.
There's like Milwaukee.
And Albany.
Albany and Corvallis, I guess, is another cities or states, I should say.
Okay.
What others? I don't know. Portland, Maine. I mean,
Salem.
Oh my gosh, yeah. Oh, so Oregon are a bunch of cheaters, huh?
Yeah, pretty much. Pretty much.
So, do you like working where you work?
I do like working where I work. I get to meet new people, and I get to make salads. And I don't work in the back where we make pizzas, but I do make most of the salads, and I do get to talk to people.
Is your favorite part of doing that talking to people, or is it serving people, or is it just being around people?
I like being around people, and I like talking to people mostly. It's kind of nice to see like what kind of different people there are out there.
Right.
Yeah, I like a lot of diversity, so.
Diversity in...
just conversations, honestly. There's some wild conversations I've had with some people, but
I can imagine,
it's pretty nice just talking to different people.
The last 2 years have been a little bit crazy for everybody.
Yes.
And so the first part of it, did you spend it inside? Did you work? What were you doing?
Let's go
through your journey with COVID.
The first part of COVID I spent inside. I was very scared of the coronavirus. I stayed inside most of it. I didn't actually start coming outside of my home during the coronavirus pandemic until like a couple months ago, like back in August is when I actually finally decided to come out and like try to get a job again. I used to work at the YMCA.
Okay.
So I used to be a lifeguard and a swim lesson instructor for children. And then now I work at a pizza place.
This might surprise you, maybe not, but I spent my entire life coaching kids and being around kids, and so I get what that's like, just like helping out your community, but more importantly, just like being around the kids and having fun with them, because that's life, right? I mean, I'm getting old. I'm an old man now, so, you know, my wisdom is coming from just the fact that I love kids and I love being around people, just like what you just said. But you've had that your entire life. So tell me a little bit more about that. Like, what does that feel like to you when you get a chance to be at the YMCA or anywhere else?
I am still here. Hi! I'm actually about to leave after this.
Oh, you better work.
I know. I'm yeah, I love it. I actually have 9 siblings.
Okay.
I'm almost the oldest. I'm number 3 in the rankings of my siblings.
Okay.
I took care of them from ages 14 to 17. I took care of them before we went into foster care. I would feed them. I would make sure they were ready to go to school. I would do my homework with them. So like kids are kind of a big part of my life anyways. I actually have a son of my own. He's almost 2.
Really? What's his name?
His name's Thomas.
What?
Thomas.
Oh, my uncle and one of my cousins are named Thomas. Yeah.
We named him after his dad's uncle or dad, so his grandpa.
Okay.
But yeah, his name is Thomas. He's great. He's a cute little blonde boy. He has like curly hair. Love him. He's taught me a lot about life.
So would he be called a towhead?
So he actually came out with brown hair.
Okay, so he'd be a towhead.
So yeah, he had a lot of hair.
If he's blonde hair now.
He's blonde now.
Yeah, yeah. No, that's a towhead. So I was a towhead, all my kids. Yeah.
I actually had brown hair when I was a kid. So and it's supposed to be blonde now, but it's actually red right now because I just dyed it.
Well, yeah, I get it, yeah.
But yeah, I used to have blonde hair. I've been a blonde my whole life.
If I go to like Southern Hemisphere or even California, my hair will turn blonde.
Okay.
And I tell my kids all the time I'm blonde, but we're up here, and they just laugh at me because I'm not blonde, but...
Yeah, no sun.
I make fun of myself, so I just tell my own blonde jokes about myself, so...
That's perfect. I love that.
So, your son is 2, and you work. What does your son do during the day?
During the day, he plays. When I'm at work, he's with his dad.
Okay.
We are co-parenting right now.
A good dad.
Yeah.
Oh, I love that. That's awesome.
He's around. We're not together, but he's around.
Okay. No, I love that. I mean, kids need both parents, so that's amazing.
That's what we have right now. We're like co-parenting with him and taking care of him like separately. When he works, I stay at home with the baby, and when I work, he stays.
That's the way it should be. Whether you are divorced, separated, never been with the person, doesn't matter. But that is how kids are gonna love their mom and dad no matter what. No matter how horrible or how great, you know what I mean? Like, so why struggle with that part of it? Which is why you're doing awesome. Like, it's amazing. And how old are you?
I'm 21. I'm almost 22 in January.
22 in January. You've already got most things figured out, except for your hair, because you're still dyeing it, figuring it out.
I'm still being crazy with it. I think I'm going purple next. So.
Purple? I like purple. Well, not really. That's a UW color. I went to USC, so if you could anyway work in cardinal and gold, I'd be really happy.
Okay.
But I know it's impossible.
Okay.
So, your favorite things to do around town, what are those?
I like to get boba.
Say that again.
I like to get boba.
Okay, that's
boba tea shop on Monroe. It's really nice. I like to drive around with friends.
Ooh.
And I used to go to Lynn Benton, so I would go to OSU to study.
Okay.
But that's pretty much it.
When you say drive around with friends, that reminds me when I was younger, and we would drive along up north by Lake Washington. It was called like Kirkland Boulevard or Kirkland or Bellevue something, Bellevue Way. Then anyways. What is your place where you guys go drive and hang out?
Avery Park.
What?
Avery Park.
Avery Park. And what's at Avery Park?
Avery Park, it's just kind of nice to like sit there and hang out with friends and like talk and have picnics. They have like the bones exhibit where there's like these really big dinosaur bones that kids can go climb on.
There is? Okay.
And there's this big train. It's like an old locomotive. It's really cool. My kid loves it. I've gotten some really good pictures there. But the train and the bones are pretty much like a big like ticket item for Avery Park. It's just really nice. They also have a creek where you can go and swim. So I've definitely gone there and swam a couple times. They have a rope swing. So it's pretty nice.
So dinosaur bones?
Yeah, dinosaur bones. Really big ones.
From here?
Yeah. They're not real bones.
Oh.
They're just like these big like plastic bones, but they're really cool for kids. So
just like Oregon's stealing the names of all the other cities and towns, they're stealing
dinosaur bones.
Exactly.
Pretty much.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Huh. Interesting.
It's pretty cool. It's a cute little exhibit. But
now, if your son is 2, and let's say he's 25 now or something, but it's the same year right now. Right? Like, so just imagine yourselves being both 25 years older right now in this period of time.
Okay.
What would you tell him besides get a job?
I would tell him to stay safe, keep an eye on the friends that you have, and mainly just stay safe because there's some crazy people out there.
There's a lot of crazy people.
There are a lot of crazy people.
I hear people dye their hair red for no reason. Have you heard of that?
I know. That's crazy. No, this is my midlife crisis.
Oh, yeah. 21. That's midlife crisis. Or
midlife
almost 21. Or what was it?
Quarter life crisis.
Yeah.
No, but stay safe. Keep an eye on the friends you have around. Make sure they're good people. And, like, you know, be
That's a great life
a
lesson.
Friend.
No, it really is a great life lesson, because as I've gotten older, like, you realize who your real friends are in life. They're the ones that are still around. Every time you get back together with them, it's like you were never apart.
Yeah.
And being a guy, I don't stay in touch with people very well.
Yeah.
Like a lot of guys, you're shaking your head. We don't do that very well. So it's awesome just that one time a year, now that I'm, you know, 500,000 years old. You know, that once a year thing is really, really meaningful to me.
Yeah.
So, but with you, I bet that you're probably pretty good at staying in touch with people.
Oh, yeah. I stay in touch with him. This was my boyfriend when I was in my freshman year of high school. I hit him up a couple weeks ago, and I was like, hey, how are you doing? And we've been talking ever since. And like,
yeah. And he's probably really bad at staying in touch with you.
Yeah, he didn't message me for a while, but...
That's what I'm betting right there.
Yeah. I'm a Capricorn. If you know anything about Capricorns, I'm very good at
Are they like unicorns? I have a little girl, so...
They're good at staying in touch. They're very methodical. So I like to plan out my days. I like to plan out my months, plan out my years. I have a planner.
Uh-oh.
I like to write things down.
Yeah.
I'm very, like, you know, methodical, but...
All right, hey, good luck, buddy, with that.
All right. Thank you. All
right. Good luck, yeah.
All right.
But yeah.
No, it's very cute. I like that a lot. And I mean cute in a very good way. That it's something special when somebody goes through life like you have, and yet you still plan. Like, when I have had hardships, I ignore stuff. I will let things go. I
definitely did that for a while.
Okay.
I've had some pretty rough times in my life, but yeah. Here lately I've thought out, like, when I write things down, it helps me more. So, like, going to therapy, getting some things, like literally little lists, like, what am I doing today? I'm going to wash my hair.
Right.
I'm going to make myself lunch. I'm going to make myself dinner. Like, little things like that
Those
has helped
very, yeah.
me so much.
That's, you know, that's an amazing lesson for even a guy like me.
Yeah.
At what I said was 5 million, I might have lied. Maybe I'm 5 trillion years old. I have
five
no idea.
Trillion.
Yeah, I don't know.
Yeah.
I was trying to be younger than, yeah. I was kidding. But you just taught me something. And I think that I will actually move that forward in my own life. Although it's kind of hard because that means I have to, like, grab a pen and
it's hard
paper.
To teach an old dog new tricks.
That was my joke.
Yeah. It's hard to teach
Good
an old
job.
Dog new tricks, but yeah. It's possible. If you just start taking little notes and, like, saying, like, I need to take my pills today, I need to take, like,
Time out. We went from, like, really happy things to pills today. What's
I'm
going
just
on?
Saying, like,
just because
notes.
I'm an old guy?
Little notes. Like, you know, gotta make sure I make breakfast, gotta make sure I make lunch, like little things like that.
I gotta make sure I take my pills, grab my cane.
Grab your cane, make sure you have your, you know, crazy pills, your eye ointment, whatever.
No, I like to leave my crazy pills at home because
okay.
it's more fun
make
not
sure
to have
to take them.
To be crazy?
Yeah, to be less crazy.
Oh, there you go. Well, see, the thing that I've learned growing up that might help you out in your life, or even you, is that everybody's crazy.
Yeah.
You just gotta find
the right kind of
your
crazy.
Type of crazy that you get along with. Mm-hmm. And it's not as easy as everybody thinks. Because we're all posers when we meet that person, right?
Yeah, for real.
And then you kind of figure things out as you go along.
Yeah.
But as time goes on, sometimes you realize friendships are good. Mm-hmm. And sometimes you realize they're bad.
Yeah.
So those are all things that we all pick up over the years. And the one thing I'm picking up tonight, though, was I learned something from you. And I appreciate it. So thank you.
Yeah.
And that is that I need to actually plan stuff out. Instead of just grabbing my camera and going to random places and videotaping random people. I'm just kidding everybody on my YouTube page. kidding. But I do need to do that in my real life. I really do. Like, there's about a million things I'm thinking of right now that I have avoided that I will do tonight and tomorrow morning. And you will never know what they are. But you did help me with it, and I appreciate it. Thank you.
I'm glad.
And what did you get out of me?
Mm-hmm. What did I get out of this? That it's fun to be on camera. I actually am a streamer.
You're a streamer?
I'm a streamer on Twitch.
Does that mean that you hang up, like, streamers? I don't get what that is. I'm sorry.
So I play video games and stream my video games. And people watch me.
Which video games?
I play Dead by Daylight, 7 Days to Die, Five Nights at Freddy's, Call of Duty.
Call of Duty, I heard of that one.
I do play Call of Duty, yes. I play Phasmophobia, and I take requests. Phasmophobia is a game where you're like a ghost hunter.
Okay.
And you have to figure out what kind of ghost it is before you die.
That sounds fun.
It's pretty fun. You should definitely try it. And then 7 Days to Die is it's a zombie apocalypse. So you have to try to, like, survive as long as you can.
Oh, that sounds like more fun.
Five Nights at Freddy's, you're in a pizzeria. You're the night guard. You have to make sure that the animatronics don't get to you.
That sounds too Disneyland 1985.
You're a survivor facing a killer. You try to strategically make sure to get out alive without getting hooked too many times where you die.
Can I tackle people or play rugby or football or anything?
You just have to hide and do your generators.
I'm not good at hiding.
It's a good game. It's pretty fun. It definitely teaches you how to hide.
Hiding isn't good though.
Hiding
we
can
just
be a
decided
good
that.
Hiding can be a good thing if you do it in the right time. I feel like if you are hiding from something, it's okay as long as you eventually face it. When you're ready.
So that's what I've been doing. So I understand that. And you're speaking to me. I get it. But also hiding to me could be there's a zombie apocalypse. I'm not going to hide and let everybody else die. I'm going to go tackle people.
I don't like the idea of a zombie apocalypse. I would definitely die at the beginning because I don't want to deal with that.
But then you'd be a zombie.
I don't
want
to deal with that.
And you'd be eating your friend's
brains. No, I wouldn't be a zombie. I think I would, take my own account and just... Because I don't think I want to deal with this zombie apocalypse. I couldn't do it.
You could.
I don't know if I could.
The thing is,
you gotta remember, women in the zombie apocalypse are only breeders. And I don't want to be a breeder.
Nope. I don't even know what that means.
It means you're there to repopulate the world.
Well, yeah, you are in the real world, though.
I don't want to be there.
Oh, no, brain into it. Okay,
yeah,
gotcha.
Brain. The whole brain of the operation.
I don't think I could.
Men couldn't survive the zombie apocalypse without women.
I don't think I could do it.
But that's kind of the same thing with, the real world, right?
Yeah, I wouldn't.
We couldn't survive without women. They're the brain of the whole operation.
And I just don't think I would want to be that if we got down to be a zombie apocalypse.
We can't have a first man without a first lady.
Yeah. I just don't think I could do it. Personally, I wouldn't want to be, the mother of all children.
Well, no, nobody's asking you to do that, but...
Well, in the zombie apocalypse...
Oh, you're overthinking it. You're overthinking it.
That's the thing that scares me. I don't want to be the mother of all children.
No, you don't have to be. You just have to breed kids with whoever you breed with.
Yeah. I would just get in my head about it, because I've seen 24 Days Later when they, made the women be the breeders, and I couldn't do that.
I haven't seen that.
It's an interesting watch. 24 and 27 weeks later, or 27 days and 27 weeks later. Those two different movies. One of them is where the women, even one of them was a 13-year-old, and they were saying that they were going to be the breeders, and they were going to be the new world. And that's what fucked me up in my head. I was like, I don't want to be that. I don't want to be the breeder.
Yeah, that's disgusting.
I just want to be there and survive.
How about instead of calling it a breeder, though, you just call it a relationship with a dumb guy? And that's normal life, right?
For real.
Well, if you put it that way, it's just a dumb guy, and you're just having kids with a dumb guy.
Yeah.
But the way I was looking at normal it was life. I'm having kids with multiple dumb guys, and I don't want to have kids with multiple
you don't have
guys.
To do that. No,
yeah,
don't
I don't
want to
do that.
Yeah.
So that's my part. I don't want to do that.
Yeah, you're not... I was going to make a bad joke. I'm not going to do that.
You have to buy me another drink if you make the bad jokes, so...
First of all... I gotta be honest with you, you're the first woman I've ever bought a drink for in my entire life.
Are you serious?
Yep. Me too.
and the only reason why is because I'm doing this special on Corvallis and
are
you
were
leaving.
YouTube?
What?
Are you posting this on YouTube?
Yeah.
Can you give me your information so I can see when it's posted?
Absolutely.
Because I do stream. I have over 1,000 followers on Twitch. I just want to make sure where my information is going.
Okay.
So I just want to see where it's going. Because if it goes in a bad direction, I just want to be able to contact you and say,
I will not be,
Okay.
You're fine.
Okay.
As you'll see, my YouTube page is very, very much like a zombie page.
Okay.
Not well thought out.
Okay.
And you could probably do it way better. But I do have a lot of followers.
Okay.
And so you should approve it.
Okay.
Definitely. 100%.
Okay.
No, without a doubt. Everybody that is on there, right? Yeah.
I would love to see it when it's done. I'd love to see this.
I'm not going
to
edit this.
Okay.
This interview has been perfect because it's real life.
Okay.
And that's what I capture. I capture real life.
I'd like to get your information so I can see it later. You post.
You will get my information. My information for everybody that's listening or watching is HealthybyHeath on YouTube.
Okay.
You're already watching it on YouTube, so you already know that. But HealthybyHeath, all one word, No spaces, because if you put a space in there, you'll get 5 trillion other healthy somethings.
Okay.
So, yeah, Healthy by Heath, one word.
Okay.
And obviously, my name's Heath.
Okay.
And it's been a real pleasure talking to you. Like, honestly, like, you are, like, one of those people that somebody like me meets in my life that reminds me of me, and I'm all about me. So I enjoy that.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Relatable.
I know I'm a great person, so okay. I like to meet other great people.
What's your sun sign?
Taurus. The best sign, yeah.
Okay, I can see that. Yeah. Okay. It's interesting that you're getting out of your comfort zone right now as a Taurus.
You're right, it is.
Because Taurus usually stay within themselves. So it's very interesting.
I'm very dynamic.
Okay.
Yeah.
I'm a Capricorn. That's why I'm so methodical. So
which one's Capricorn?
Capricorn is like January, December. So that's where we plan things out.
January, December. You mean January, February?
January, December. So December, January.
December, okay. Yeah.
Sorry, it's right after Sagittarius, right before Aquarius.
One of my best friends was born. Yeah, yeah. Yeah, he...
very methodical, very thought out, very planned. That's why I'm so like list. And plans.
This is a shout out to Mike Vitar, who used to be in the Mighty Ducks movies and